Finding the right size for your wind turbine is crucial. When the wind turbine is too big, you spend too much money. Too small, and it won't produce enough electricity. The key is to match the wind turbine's power output to your energy needs. In this video, you'll learn step by step how to choose the perfect size for a wind turbine based on your needs and your location. You'll also discover a common mistake many make when sizing their turbine and how to avoid it, making you an insider. Hi, I'm Patrick. On this channel, you can see how small wind power really works in practice. The primary objective when sizing a small wind turbine? The annual electricity production of the wind turbine must match the electricity demand of the owner. Electricity generated by your turbine that cannot be used and cannot be stored is obviously wasted. The question is, how big does your turbine need to be to generate the amount of electricity you can actually use? What determines a wind turbine's electricity production? Primarily, it's the wind energy at rotor height and the size of the rotor. The stronger the wind and the larger the rotor, the more electricity a wind turbine will produce. So, what do we need to find out to be able to find the right size of a wind turbine? Number one, the desired electricity production from the wind turbine. Make up your mind how much electricity your turbine should generate annually. I will show you an example in a moment. So, number two is the wind energy at rotor height. You have to find out how strong the wind is at your location. As an example for sizing a wind turbine, we take a small company in the USA at a windy location in the countryside. The company's annual electricity consumption is 50,000 kilowatt hours, and the company's own solar system can cover 20,000 kilowatt hours of this. This leaves 30,000 kilowatt hours of electricity demand per year. Now we have to find out how much electricity our own wind turbine should generate per year. With reference to our example, a first thought would be that the wind turbine should provide the remaining demand of 30,000 kilowatt hours per year. But that is not the case. No, the turbine should generate much less to maximize the self-consumption of the electricity it produces. The lower the electricity production of the wind turbine in relation to the electricity demand, the greater the self-consumption will be. With a rather small wind turbine, there's a greater chance that the electricity from the wind turbine will be used and not wasted. We apply a rule of thumb. The owner's annual electricity demand should be 2 to 3 times as much as the turbine's annual production, especially if no electricity storage is available. The turbine should produce a maximum of 50% with regard to the electricity demand of the owner. So, if the remaining demand of the company is 30,000 kilowatt hours per year, the wind turbine should provide a maximum of about 15,000 kilowatt hours. This gives us the first value for sizing the wind turbine. Annual production from the turbine with a maximum of 15,000 kilowatt hours. Now, we need to determine the wind energy at the location of the company. Knowing the specific wind energy at your location is essential for selecting a wind turbine. Wind energy generally means average annual wind speed in meters per second. When talking about wind energy, it's essential to consider the height above ground. There's often a significant difference between having your rotor 10 meters or 30 feet above ground compared to 40 meters or 120 feet. At 40 meters, the wind is much stronger than at 10 meters. A small off-grid microwind turbine might be 10 meters high, while a farmer's turbine could be 30 to 50 meters high. You can determine the average wind speed for your property either through a wind measurement or by using a remote analysis tool like the Global Wind Atlas or your country's wind resource map. For example, for the United States, the Department of Energy provides wind energy maps including data for 30 meters above ground. A good location has an average annual wind speed of at least 5 meters per second at rotor height. If the wind on your property is too weak, then a small wind turbine does not make sense. I've made an extra video on when a location is suitable for a wind turbine and how to conduct a site check. You'll find the link to that video in the description below, but first watch this video here to the end. Let's return to our example. The owner of the company estimates the wind resource of his location on the basis of wind maps. His result? He expects a minimum of 5 meters per second average annual wind speed. The next step is to find a suitable wind turbine. The owner of the company is looking for a wind turbine that can generate about 15,000 kilowatt hours per year at its location with an average wind speed of about 5 meters per second. But where should he look for a turbine? The market for small wind turbines is confusing and not every manufacturer can be recommended. Please remember, when choosing a wind turbine, only high-quality wind turbines will survive the next storms. There's a lot of poor quality on the market. I will give you some tips at the end of the video. Therefore, we'll look at a particularly trustworthy source, a list of high-quality small wind turbines tested and certified in the USA. We check the website of the US Small Wind Certification Council. This table shows us the small wind turbines that are currently certified in the USA. These systems have passed extensive tests and thus proven their quality. We mainly look at the column with the annual energy production. Note, these annual electricity yields are for an average annual wind speed of 5 meters per second. This is practical for our example because this wind speed exists at the location of the company. We see at the bottom of the line a turbine that generates 13,800 kilowatt hours per year, close to our target of 15,000 kilowatt hours. It's the XL10 model by the US manufacturer Berge Wind Power. Now let's take a look at the size of the wind turbine. Clicking on the left column gives us more information about the product. Here we see important data on a label such as the annual electricity yield or rated power of the wind turbine. Various documents can be downloaded below for more detailed information on the tested wind turbine. Here I download the following file, SWCC 1012 certificate. In this document, we find the information about the wind turbine we are looking for. Under the specifications for the wind turbine, we can read rotor diameter 7 meters, rated power 8.9 kilowatt at a wind speed of 11 meters per second, peak power 12.6 kilowatt at a wind speed of 16.5 meters per second. This means the company now knows it needs a 10 kilowatt class turbine with a rotor diameter of about 7 meters. As an extra tip, I recommend that you download also the summary report for a wind turbine and there look at a specific table, the tabulated annual energy production, AEP. Here you can see how much electricity a small wind turbine generates at different average wind speeds. For example, if you have an average wind speed of 4 meters per second at your location, the Berge XL10 turbine would generate approximately 7,100 kilowatt hours per year. If you have an exceptionally good location with 6 meters per second average wind speed, the turbine could even produce 22,000 kilowatt hours of electricity. Here you can see what a huge influence the wind resource of a location has on the electricity production of a wind turbine. Now let's address the most common mistake in determining the size of a wind turbine. What do you think is more important? A. The generator's power in kilowatts, or B. The size of the rotor? It is the size of the rotor. The rotor size tells us much more about the wind turbine's electricity production than the power of the generator. Why is the size of the rotor crucial? Consider the following comparison. In the table, two wind turbines are compared, both advertised by the manufacturers to have a nominal power of 5 kilowatts. However, turbine B generates much more electricity. For example, at an average annual wind speed of 4 meters per second, turbine A generates 3,400 kilowatt hours and turbine B generates 4,900 kilowatt hours of electricity per year. This is because the rotor diameter is only 1 meter or 3 feet larger. Visually, you will hardly notice the larger rotor, but it makes a significant difference in electricity production. Therefore, when selecting a wind turbine, you should primarily look at the rotor size. The nominal power can be misleading. Finally, here's a brief overview of the steps required for sizing a wind turbine. Step number one, determine the annual electricity production of the wind turbine and use the rule of thumb. The annual production of the wind turbine should be a maximum of half the electricity demand. Number two, determine the average annual wind speed at your location. Number three, look for a suitable wind turbine from a high quality manufacturer. And number four, based on the rotor diameter, find other suitable wind turbines for comparison. And please keep in mind that this guide is intended for the first simple steps in planning a small wind turbine. Anyone spending a lot of money on a wind turbine should consider seeking professional help. This can be manufacturers of small wind turbines or independent experts, such as engineers specializing in wind energy projects. If you are considering taking the next steps towards wind energy, my video about buying a small wind turbine will be helpful. Click on this link on your screen now or find it in the description below. Don't miss it. This video shows you what really matters when choosing a small wind turbine. Thanks for watching and take care.